It's a London-wide problem epitomised in Brent's housing office. Too many homeless families, not enough homes, bed and breakfast, the overnight answer that becomes a two-year stopgap between the streets and a rent book. In this borough, over 600 families depend on bed and breakfast, but a shortage of hotels forces them out of Brent into Bayswater and Earl's Court, where they can easily feel forgotten. Back at Brent Town Hall, the council is hung. Tories deny a housing crisis and point to 800 empty council homes and over 3,000 rooms to let in the private sector. Labour point to a government that curbs council spending on homes and pays half of the £3.5 million Brent spends in B&B hotels.
One measure which we would like to introduce is the use of the Criminal Trespass Act, which would allow us to evict squatters who have no right to our property whatsoever out of those properties and take people from the homelessness list immediately. That would release somewhere of the order of 40 or 50 units straight away. And there are lots of other measures that we can pursue along those lines as well.
Labour's attack is based on secret inspections of the B&B hotels.
The conditions have to be seen to be believed. And of course, in these overcrowded, poor social conditions, diseases that perhaps were only last rife at the end of the 19th century are starting to show their face again.
What is your alternative?
Well, my alternative is partly to use the money that we're using at the moment more sensibly.
Labour want to subsidise mortgages, build or buy more homes, even invest staff pension funds in a hotel they can control. Tories want to finance housing associations and extend private leasing schemes. Other options, including utilising schools and community halls, will be debated tonight. Everyone wants to redirect hotel bills into homes, but while Brent disagrees, the homeless have little hope. David Bellin, Thames News.